ஜீவன் முக்தி பிரதம் தேவம் க்ஷமாபூர்ணம் ஜகத்குரும் வந்தே பரமஹம் சாக்கியம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஜீவன் முக்தி பிரதம் தேவம் க்ஷமாபூர்ணம் ஜகத்குரும் வந்தே பரமஹம் சாக்கியம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஆனந்தானுபவாஸ்வாதம் சர்வரோக நிவாரகம் வந்தே பாப விநாசக்தம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஆனந்தானுபவாஸ்வாதம் சர்வரோக நிவாரகம் வந்தே பாப விநாசக்தம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். நித்யமுக்தம் நிர்விகல்பம் தியானலோக பிரதீபகம்.
பரமஹம்ச நித்யானந்தா ఈ శతాబ్దపు మరువలేని పోలికలేని ఒక ఆధ్యాత్మిక శక్తి, ఒక అంతర్జాతీయ సాంఘిక ఆధ్యాత్మిక ప్రభంజనాన్ని స్థాపించిన ఒక అద్భుత శక్తి, వైదిక ధర్మాన్ని పునరుద్ధరించడానికి ఉద్భవించిన ఒక చైతన్య శక్తి. ఆయన అతి పవిత్రమైన తిరువన్నామలై క్షేత్రంలో జన్మించారు. ఒక యోగిగా జన్మించి తనలో సహజంగానే పొంగిపొరలే ఆధ్యాత్మికతను కోట్ల మందికి పంచుతూ స్ఫూర్తినిచ్చే ఒక అమోఘ శక్తి. అతి పురాతనమైన యోగా విద్యలో ప్రావీణ్యం కలిగి ఆధ్యాత్మిక శాస్త్రాన్ని క్షుణ్ణంగా పరిశోధన చేసిన ఒక మహాద్భుతమైన అంతఃప్రపంచపు పరిశోధకులు, ఆత్మజ్ఞానాన్ని ప్రసాదించే గురువులు. ప్రతి సంవత్సరం పరమహంస నిత్యానంద ఆయన జ్ఞానామృతాన్ని, ఆనందం వెదజల్లే ఆయన చిరునవ్వుని, తిరుగులేని ఆయన దీక్ష యొక్క శక్తిని 1 కోటికి పైగా ఉన్న ఆయన శిష్యులకు పంచుతున్నారు. ఇప్పుడు పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మీరు జీవన్ముక్తులుగా జీవించటానికి తోడ్పడే పరిష్కారాలను మీకు అందజేస్తున్నారు. ఒక మరువలేని ఆధ్యాత్మిక అనుభవం కొరకు మమ్మల్ని వెంటనే సంప్రదించండి.
వేద వేదాంత సంవేద్యం దేవదేవీ స్వరూపిణం వందే వటపలాశిస్థం.
Teaching is of two types. One, introducing some new truth and raising you to the next spectrum, or clearing the ideas with which you are living and making them straight. Just clearing the ideas with which you are living and making them straight is a lot more easy. Because when you are confused, you are not ready to listen to new concepts, new ideas, new truths. You feel already what is inside itself is such a big headache. Why allow something more inside? No. You are closed. You are tired. You are sick. You don't want to take any risk. Understand? Trusting a new truth is always a risk. That is why only a happy man, man who is luxurious in his inner space, can afford religion. Only a man who has more money than what is required for his basic needs can afford luxuries. Same way, only a person who has more energy in his inner space than to run his day-to-day life can afford religion. Only if you are having excess energy than required to run your day-to-day life, you look beyond. Something, some light is coming through this window, through this door openings. What must be beyond this wall? Why don't I try to look? Looking beyond, what is seen happens only when you have more energy than what you need to run your day-to-day life. That is why a confused man lives till his death as atheist. How can he have energy to look beyond, to go beyond, to be beyond? No? I have seen in thousands of monasteries in India where Bhagavad Gita is taught freely, giving food and stay together. But it is so unfortunate. You can't understand Bhagavad Gita unless you are a person of life. Now, before forgetting, I wanted to put it on record, my gratitude to the great sadhu Ramananda Saraswati of Omkareshwar, at whose feet I learnt Sanskrit version of Bhagavad Gita. I have studied Bhagavad Gita in a very young age through a translation by Swami Chidbhavananda. He has done an amazing translation in Tamil. But a great sadhu, Ramananda Saraswati of Omkareshwar, great, very great way of living. Amazing sadhu, lived for quite a long time. I think he lived at least above 90. He used to stay in Omkareshwar in Madhya Pradesh. He will stay there for 6 months and teach Bhagavad Gita. Whoever comes to learn, he will give them free food and shelter. When he finishes the course after 6 months, he will start living his parivarajaka life. He will go from house to house and beg and eat, sleep under the trees. Whatever money he gets from the devotees, whatever contribution he gets, he will collect all that for 6 months, keep it with him. By the end of the 6 months, he will come back to Omkareshwar and start teaching. Again, when I studied at his feet, around 1,700 people lived with him. The whole Omkareshwar will be filled by his disciples. Omkareshwar is a small place, but there are many ashrams. He had his own ashram. Ashram is not a huge infrastructure, a reasonable place. He will start the classes again. After 6 months, again, he will go for yatra. Sometimes devotees will come and tell, why do you travel? No, you stay here, we will get you money and you start teaching. He says, no. I wanted to go door to door and beg and come back, teach Gita. Till his life.
Kalpataru. మీలోని కుండలిని శక్తిని తెలుసుకోగల ఒక ప్రత్యేక కార్యక్రమము కల్పతరు. పూర్తిగా ఒకరోజు జరిగే ఈ కార్యక్రమములో ఆరోగ్యకరమైన అద్భుతమైన మార్పును పొందగలరు. అవతారమూర్తి పరమహంస నిత్యానంద స్వామి వారి ఆశీస్సులను ప్రత్యేకంగా పొందగల కార్యక్రమం కల్పతరు. కుండలిని అంటే ఏమిటి? కుండలిని అంటే ప్రతి ఒక్కరిలోనూ దాగి ఉన్న అద్భుత శక్తి. కుండలిని శక్తి ఒక ధ్యానోదయమైన గురుదేవుల దీక్షతో చైతన్యపరచవచ్చు. ఈ కుండలిని శక్తి మీ జీవితంలో అన్ని దశలలోనూ అభివృద్ధికరమైన మార్పులను తేగలిగే శక్తి. అది మీలో ఆరోగ్యాన్ని, ఐశ్వర్యాన్ని, విజయాన్ని, ఆనందాన్ని, ఆధ్యాత్మిక ధ్యానోదయాన్ని కలిగిస్తుంది. ప్రతి వారాంతములో కల్పతరు కార్యక్రమం బిరిది ఆశ్రమంలో నిర్వహించబడును. మమ్మల్ని సంప్రదించవలసిన చిరునామా: నిత్యానంద ధ్యానపీఠం, నిత్యానంద నగర్, బిడది 562109 బెంగళూరు. ఫోన్ చేయవలసిన నంబరు 09555000550 లేదా 09618519701. మా వెబ్సైట్ www.nityananda.org.
Till he left the body, he lived the same life. 6 months he will sit and teach Gita, and 6 months he will spend in begging, going from door to door. He will not stay more than 2 days in a place. Amazing sadhu life he lived. I wanted to remember him and offer my gratitude. It is at his feet I studied Bhagavad Gita in original Sanskrit. Powerful teacher. But it is so unfortunate, the disciples are not powerful disciples. Most of them are there for food and shelter. Most of these local beggars, they wear the sadhu clothes, come and stay there, He is such a sincere person. He will never miss three session. Per day, three session he will take. Before breakfast one, before lunch one, before dinner one. Three sessions. He will never miss a session. People will never miss three meal, breakfast, lunch and dinner. But in the class, I don't know. I can't even tell exactly how many people will be sitting in the class. 1,700 people lived around him when I was studying. Very few will come and sit in the class throughout. You see, otherwise they will come for one session. All of them will attend at least one session a day. That also not with the sincerity of internalizing. I used to think, oh God, these fellows are given food, very good stay. Why are they not studying? Now I know the answer. You cannot allow any idea to infiltrate you. You cannot internalize any idea unless you are life. You are for life. As I said, non-suffering should become your religion. Non-suffering should become your life standard. Non-suffering should be echoing in your every thought, deed, action, word, in everything. See, from today, all over Bengal, West Bengal, especially in Calcutta, anywhere you stand, you will hear that word, Jaima, 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 Jaima. It will be echoing all over the West Bengal. Durga Puja. Durga Puja starts. I have seen Mumbai Ganesh Chaturthi. I have seen Tamil Nadu Skanda Shashti. I have seen Tiruvannamalai Deepam. I have seen so many big festivals. But nothing like Navaratri. Durga Puja of West Bengal. Oh God. People live with her. Bengalis are basically the devotion-based people. They literally live with her. See, if you have a daughter, how you save money and you get her to your house for Diwali or some other celebration and you spend all the money on her, give her a lot of gifts and send them back to her house. Exactly same way, even a middle class, lower middle class man in Bengal will save money. All of them look upon Devi as a daughter. Daughter is called home for this Navaratri day, 9 days. She is given all the gifts and she is taken care and she is sent back to Kailash after the Dasami, 10th day. I should say, people are literally in Bhava Samadhi. These 10 days they live in Bhava Samadhi. The way they bring the Devi to the house, the deity, and the way the puja happens, the way they spend. If somebody is making 1,000 rupees per month, I can easily tell, I can safely tell, he will spend 2,000 rupees just for this Durga Puja. At least 2 months income, they will save it and spend on Devi, Durga Puja. Whole Bengal will vibrate with that one word, Jaima, 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 day and night. Just how Bengal reverberates with Devi. Your life should reverberate with one truth, non-suffering. Only then you are ready for internalizing new truths, great truths like Bhagavad Gita. Man who can internalize new truths is living enlightenment. Man who can alter his logic, clear his logic and get rid of his confusions is a seeker. Man who can neither internalize new truths nor get rid of his confusion by altering his understanding is atheist. I don't know what I'm saying. Expected to reach at least 1 lakh people per day. In the beginning, God created the earth and rested. Then God created man, who are his devotees, peace and rested. Then God created atheist. Since then, neither God nor devotees rested. Atheist is a person who lives a substandard life, who can't allow the new truths, new ideas inside him, who can't internalize new concepts into his being. It's very difficult to live as atheist. You can act as atheist, that is okay. But living as atheist is very, very difficult. One atheist complained to a Christian friend, "You Christians have their special, your special holidays, Christmas and Easter. Jews celebrate their holidays. Hindus celebrate their holidays. Muslims have their holidays. Every religion has its holidays. But we atheists have no recognized holidays. It's an unfair discrimination." The religious person, he said, "What do you mean? Atheists have no holidays. People have been observing a special day in your honor for years." Atheist said, "I don't know what you are talking about. When is this special day?" The religious person, Christian, said, "April 1st. Atheist is a man who can't internalize, who can't allow expansion of inner space. Here, Bhagavan does not want to give too much load on Arjuna. Please understand, Arjuna is not in the level of atheist, but still he has to come to the level of living enlightenment. He is a seeker. So Bhagavan is clearing Arjuna's own doubts and wrong logic and making it straight. He is not putting new ideas into Arjuna. In this verse, Bhagavan is saying, all right, even if you don't believe the truth I am introducing, Atma, the soul, is indestructible, eternal. Life is far internalizing the newer and newer and greater truths. Krishna says, even if you are not able to internalize the great truths like soul is eternal, it is indestructible, and all these things, come on, even if you believe that birth and death are inevitable, O Arjuna, foremost among men, is using the beautiful word for Arjuna, Mahabahu, the mighty armed one. It is not worthy of being mourned for this manner. You don't need to worry about it. He is using a very powerful name for Arjuna, mighty armed one. Means, you see, the arms, the hands are directly related to giving. That is why when they describe Karna and Sri Ramachandra Prabhu, they describe their hands first. Even Sri Rama, supposed to be a great giver, Ramakrishna used to do, whenever somebody comes to him, And as for sannyas, he will hold their hand and see. Hand is supposed to look big, very light. That is the scale. It should not look small and very heavy. He will say that only by holding the hand and weighing it, if it looks big and weighs light, then this guy will become sadhu. Means he has less engram and he has capacity to give away everything. Here, Krishna is describing Arjuna as Mahabahu, means mighty arm. Surely, Arjuna must have had the quality. Big hand, but light weight, means the capacity to give everything, capacity to give away. He's reminding Arjuna, hey, you are capable of giving away your body, giving away everything. So don't worry. You are a great giver. I tell you.
ఒక అవతార పురుషుని దివ్య సలహాను నేరుగా పొందాలనుకుంటున్నారా? ఇప్పుడు మీకు పరమహంసతో ముఖాముఖి.
నిత్యానందం, నిత్యానందా హియర్.
పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మరొక్కసారి పోలిక లేని ఒక విభిన్నమైన కానుకను ప్రపంచానికి
అందచేస్తున్నారు.
ఆయన ఇప్పుడు ప్రతిరోజు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారం అయ్యే సత్సంగంలో మీ ప్రశ్నలకి జవాబు ఇవ్వడానికి సిద్ధముగా ఉన్నారు. ఉదయం 8 గంటలకు మా నంబరు 0807-272-9999 ఫోన్ చేసే అదృష్టవంతులకు ఆయనతో నేరుగా మాట్లాడే దివ్యమైన అవకాశం దక్కుతుంది. మరియు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారం అయ్యే సత్సంగం ntv.nityananda.org చూడగలరు.
The joy of giving, the habit of giving will bring its result in you when you leave the body. When you leave the body, person who is always giving, giving, who is habituated to depart from something which he feels as part of his life. If you are habituated for that, the leaving the body will be very easy. For example, you are having a house. For 10 years you lived in it, you felt it's almost your life. Suddenly one day morning you give it away. Now you are habituated to give away things which you feel as your life. Same way money. Sometimes you hold money as your life. Suddenly one day you give away. Same way. Sometimes you hold your comforts, luxury, pleasures as part of your life. Suddenly one day you give it away. Now you are habituated. You are trained for giving away what you feel as your life. So when you leave the body also, because of that habit, you will not have suffering. You are already habituated to give away. You can easily give away life also, body also. I tell you, the highest capacity you need to develop in the human life is capacity to give away. Capacity to go on giving. Giving your energy, giving your time, giving your love, giving your money, giving your, whatever you call it as yours, talent, capacity to give away. Every time when Krishna describes certain truths, he reminds Arjuna exactly the truth related name. He says, Mahabaho, mighty armed one who gave away everything, who is habitual giver. Nobody can give like Krishna. But he himself calls Arjuna as Mahabaho. జస్ట్ టు రిమైండ్ అర్జున ఈస్ అ హ్యాబిచువల్ గివర్ యు ఆర్ హ్యాబిచువేటెడ్ ఫర్ గివింగ్ అవే డోంట్ వరీ డోంట్ బి బాదర్డ్ బి ఎ గివర్ ఫర్ అ గివర్ లైఫ్ అండ్ డెత్ ఇస్ నాట్ అ బిగ్ థింగ్ హి సేస్ ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ యు బిలీవ్ దట్ బర్త్ అండ్ డెత్ ఆర్ ఇన్ఎవిటబుల్ ఫర్ దిస్ బీయింగ్ ఈవెన్ దెన్ ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ వర్ది ఆఫ్ బీయింగ్ మూన్ ఫర్ ఇన్ దిస్ మేనర్ సేస్ ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ యు బిలీవ్ బర్త్ అండ్ డెత్ ఆర్ ఇన్ఎవిటబుల్ ఫర్ వన్ హూ ఇస్ డెడ్ therefore on this ground it does not deserve on your part to mourn for that which is unavoidable the act of fighting is indeed an obligatory duty nitya karma of the kshatriyas like agnihotra bhagwan is trying to clear the confusion of arjuna without introducing any new theme or concept or idea he is saying జాతస్య హి ధ్రువో మృత్యు సేయింగ్ డెత్ ఈస్ ఇన్ఎవిటబుల్ ఫర్ అ పర్సన్ బాన్ అండ్ బర్త్ ఈస్ ఇన్ఎవిటబుల్ ఫర్ వన్ హూ ఈస్ డెడ్ దేర్ ఫోర్ ఆన్ దిస్ గ్రౌండ్ ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ డిజర్వ్ ఆన్ యువర్ పార్ట్ టు మూన్ ఫర్ దట్ విచ్ ఇస్ అనవాయిడబుల్ ఐ థింక్ దిస్ వర్డ్ షుడ్ బి టేకన్ యాజ్ అ స్ట్రైట్ వర్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద క్లోజెస్ట్ పర్సన్ whom you trust. Cycle of birth and death is going to go on forever. It is your intelligence. You have only one possibility. You can just unclutch and escape from it. You can just step out of the cycle. That's all. You can't stop the cycle. You can stop the cycle for you. When you step out, the cycle stops for you. That is why Bhagavan says, don't grieve. Over the inevitable. This is the way it is. Don't grieve for others. Death is inevitable for a person born, and birth is inevitable for one who is dead. Therefore, on this ground, it does not deserve on your part to mourn for that which is unavoidable. He says, don't worry, it is just life. Every day, whatever you think as you is dying. What is you is taking birth. Please understand, death is inevitable, birth is inevitable, and don't mourn for it. Here Bhagavan is saying it should lead you to more and more joy and courage, not to more and more suffering, pain and discouraging. Sit with this one great truth. Death and birth are simple facts. It is my decision whether to live with it or suffer for it. Sit and decide not to suffer. నా త్వం శోచితుం అర్హసి భగవాన్ రిపీట్స్ దిస్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ సెకండ్ టైం డోంట్ మిస్ ఇట్ నౌ